be able to regroup at halftime and have the second half that
you did? Yeah, the first half didn't end how I wanted it to, but all my teammates and coaches came up behind me and they huddled, like, came behind me and kept encouraging me. So it really helped me boost my confidence. So that helped a lot, just them talking to me, all them coming up to me.
When you hit the long ball to Johnny, what did that do for your confidence and your ability to just kind of get in rhythm and feel comfortable?
That was good. I think the first half I kind of got thrown out there at the end, and it wasn't really a good situation. But second half, I felt like I was calm and went out there and just played my game how I do in practice. So.
Coach said you kind of took a breath at halftime.
Yep.
And did anybody say anything to you that settled you down, or is it just the reality of the situation sink in?
No, I just told myself it's just like practice. You know, I've been doing it all week, so it transfers over to the game. So just stay calm out there.
Have you ever been thrown in a situation like that before?
Yeah, a few times before. So that's pretty much all I've been in since I've been here. I've never really got to settle in, so that was my first time. So it was good for me. It was good for my confidence. It was good, yeah. I finally got to stay in and do my thing, do what I'm used to doing.
Was there a play where it clicked, where it was like, okay, I'm in this, I feel good?
Maybe after the first touchdown when LT scored, I think they're like, okay, we can come back and win this. So that was good.
Coach talked about that he's so confident because you do this in practice all the time. What's it mean to do it Friday night in prime time, nationally televised?
It definitely feels good to finally show it in the game. I mean, I do it. I work so hard, and we all work so hard in practice, and finally go out there and do it. It feels good.
And people have seen for months of practice what Johnny can do. What was it like to see him do that?
I'm glad he can put it on display. Like he's done it every single day in practice, and shown his ability that he's one of the best in the country. So I'm glad he got to put it on display now.
What was Jordan doing for you in the second half? As far as
he was good. Yeah, he was on the sideline talking to me every time I came off the field. So he really helped me, just telling me what he saw out there. So he really helped me.
You had a big 3rd-and-9 scramble, kept a drive alive there. How important do you think that
was? That was good. Just nobody probably thought I could use my feet, and just running it felt good because I haven't really scrambled for a big game since like high school. So it was good. Your first down.
That last touchdown you threw to Johnny, I mean, they're crashing on, expecting running. When the play call was going to be the play call, I mean, were you excited to have that person throw?
Yeah,
that
I knew pretty much I had one read inside out, and I knew pretty much where I was going with the ball. So I was excited to throw that.
What does it mean to you to see at halftime no one hanging their head, everyone having confidence in you? And
I think this team has really grown since I first got here, and just we used to back down when adversity hit, and when adversity hits now, we all clap it up and come together as a team and go out there and be confident.
What has caused that evolution?
I think just coming together more and just being like a family, like brothers. I think we've got better at that every single year. I think this performance helped my confidence, definitely. I just go out next week and work.
Did you get a breaker off?
I didn't, no. It was Johnny. So.
Were you hoping it might be?
No, he shouted, Coach Norvell shouted me out before the rock was broken, so that was good, but I'm glad he got a break the rock because he played a hell of a game.
We good?
All good.
Thanks, Tate. Thanks, guys.
Thank you, Tate.
Congrats.